Welcome back. We'll get right on into it with Gunner and his bullet-dumping Leadstorm minigun. Of its 7 overclocks to choose, it has 3 straightforward damage ups, which is a red flag, but luckily they're all worth mentioning. A little more oomph gets a spot, not because of its damage bonus, but because of its unique spin-up buff, which makes the gun feel way better and opens up plenty of mod choices. Conversely, for maximum clunkiness, you can outright forfeit your movement in exchange for Leadstorm's enormous damage up. It's definitely a challenging trade-off, especially with a stun penalty, but all it takes is a small movement tech, or maybe just seeing it melt bugs to understand why it's so great. Then the in-between option, Exhaust Vectoring, gives a notable damage boost, though right alongside an also notable accuracy penalty. If you're planning on playing up close, though, it won't matter at all, and this will easily be one of your best options. That playstyle also extends to Burning Hell, since it burns any bug directly in front of the barrel, and against swarmers, instantly ignites. Also, the faster overheat can feel like a buff with how well it enables the Tier 5 mods. Which brings me to Thin Drum Walls. The added heat management has dubious synergy with the Tier 5s, and as a quality of life buff, it's kind of in a losing battle against a little more oomph spin-up. As for its ammo buff, well, the bonus from a separate overclock, Compact Feed Mechanism, will keep you going for far, far longer. But anyways, the final overclock, Bullet Hell, is off the walls. Literally. Your bullets ricochet off anything they hit and directly into any bug that's nearby. Sure, you do feel the downsides, but it's way too silly to pass up. And so, with an impressive 6 out of 7 very usable overclocks, which do have some interesting gimmicks but also tend to be a bit straightforward, the minigun takes a spot at A. Then we have the lumbering but explosive Thunderhead. It's a weapon that, for me at least, is kind of underwhelming, which I feel also extends to its overclocks. Just take composite drums for example. It gives you ammo. The base weapon is lacking in a number of ways, though definitely not in ammo. And even if you somehow needed more, there's already some really strong options for that in the Tier 1 mods, so I really don't know how to use an overclock that just gives slightly more on top. Another strange overclock is combat mobility, which, don't get me wrong, the array of buffs here is definitely nice, but its single downside hurts. Considering the Thunderhead's focus on sustain, paired with the awfully slow reload, having the mag size is a bigger hit than you might guess. That might be worth the price though, since actually hitting the bugs you're aiming at is a luxury of its own. But really though, the strangest part is just how another overclock, Big Bertha, exists. It shares the biggest upsides and downsides, so they tend to both play and build similarly. But rather than firing faster, Big Bertha instead hits much, much harder. And in my experience, that simple difference means it gets far more mileage from both the extra accuracy and additional mods, while also being hit way less by the downsides. So for a more consistent, aim-rewarding, and just better feeling Thunderhead, I find it hard to not go for Big Bertha. But anyways, onto an overclock with a completely different approach, there's Carpet Bomber. It just embraces the inaccuracy and instead gives massive buffs on all things AoE, lending it all the power it needs to reliably clear both wide and dense swarms of bugs. Unfortunately, this means it also overshadows the more minor AoE buffs of splintering shells. Then finally, there's the biggest oddity of all, though not in an underwhelming way. Combined with the Tier 5 Fear mod, Neurotoxin payload, and its ability to freely dish out Neurotoxin, is so powerful against swarms that it actually trivializes the game. Without fear, it's instead a challenging but rewarding crowd control tool that sits somewhere between Driller's Flames and Sludge. And though I dislike how it is with fear, I can't say that this overclock doesn't have a niche. And so, the stuff here is decently transformative and plays off the heavy weaponry concept pretty well, which saves it from being lower. But with only 3 out of 6, maybe 4 on a good day being usable, and some very strange power imbalances as well, I think that earns it a C tier. Next, we've got another explosive weapon, the laser-guided Hurricane Rocket System. And I gotta say, it's an easy S. Overtuned Feed Mechanism is one of the nicest cleans in the game, because of how badly the Hurricane wants rate of fire. And Fragmentation Missiles is a straightforward but noticeable AoE overclock, so if you don't want to use the Thunderhead for AoE, this is a genuine alternative. Every other overclock is insanely transformative. Plasma Bursters' weird, hyper-maneuverable missiles reward you with an efficient and flashy mode of damage if you can both track and transition between targets well. And rather than aiming at bugs, Mind Layer System's devastatingly powerful mines reward you for aiming at the path ahead of them. Then Jet Fuel Homebrew gives you hard-hitting, high-speed missiles to smash weak points with, while Salvo Module lets you charge up missiles to unleash later as an unguided cone of bug destruction. And finally, Rocket Barrage can feel a bit weak sometimes, but letting loose an incessant stream of missiles is something that's always worth a spin, so no real points off there. That leaves the Hurricane at 7 out of 7 easily usable overclocks, while also fitting so many little gimmicks into the already distinct mechanics of launching laser-guided rockets. Again, easy S. Now on to Gunner's secondaries, we first have his reliable grunt-popping Bulldog Revolver, a solid weapon with some solid overclocks, but first we need to get Chain Hit out of the way. I really wanted to call this one usable, but it ends up being just sorta better than nothing. To elaborate on that, its leg up over the competition is that it's just free damage, except it's also contingent on RNG, there being another enemy nearby, you actually hitting a weak point, and the ricochet bullet not just terminating itself on heavy armor, terrain, or yourself. It's almost notable when combined with explosive rounds and neurotoxin for use against swarms, but unfortunately there's a far easier way to use that build with magic bullets. It not only shares Chain Hit's ricochet gimmick, but also bounces with no RNG and off of any terrain, making it both consistent and intuitive to use, especially while the bugs are still in the cave walls. And as my last case against Chain Hit, if you do actually want extra damage at random, you're better off using Homebrew Powder. A quarter less damage at worst and a full double damage at best is quite a favorable gamble, and just a silly way to get more out of the gun. Though if you're not the gambling type and want only high rolls, you can throw an elephant round and reliably chunk down any tougher targets. Just mind the recoil. And then, in case you wanted those targets to somehow go down even quicker, you can channel the absolutely absurd 4x damage of volatile bullets. Just mind the fine print. And finally, there's Six Shooter. More bullets at the ready, more bullets in reserve, and just more bullets per second make it a perfect choice for those who want a revolver that involves a lot less reloading and far more shooting. Overall, that makes for a very respectable 5 out of 6 usable overclocks. Also, all of which are notable extensions of the revolver archetype, making the Bulldog a very comfortable A tier. Then on to the snappy, burst fire Burt pistol. It has a lot of overclocks, but I'm gonna be honest, really just 4 usable ones. First off, Lead Spray shreds through bugs, and by itself, outclasses nearly every other Burt overclock with just how much damage you get. But for those who don't like the inaccuracy, Experimental Rounds serves as a proper, more flexible alternative, which leaves Full Chamber Seals, comparatively tiny damage and reload buffs to be far overshadowed. But if you don't need damage and just want more standard Burt action, Compact Mags might be your only pick. The ammo boost is significant, and the downside is insignificant, which are things I can't say about the other two ammo overclocks. Composite Casing's ammo boost is minuscule, and Microfliches are in the same unsatisfyingly weak vein as mini shells, if not worse. But on a separate note, there's Electromindlets, which adds quirky electrical mines to the gun that can easily apply electricity's ridiculous slow to an entire swarm. And that's kind of it for the Burt. While it pains me to say, I think this is the worst overclock spread in the game. 3 almost painfully straightforward overclocks for damage, 3 more for ammo, and only 1 truly transformative overclock. Then out of those 7, I'd say that just 4, barely over half, are genuinely usable. The Burt is our first and probably only D tier. But enough negativity, here we have the portable jack-of-all-trades railgun, the coil gun. Between the insane pierce and lingering damage trail, it's got quite the quirks for its 6 overclocks to play into. And to kick that off, ultramagnetic coils with its extra duration and radius gives you an easy and effective way to get quite a lot out of the trail. But for anyone who just doesn't care for the feature, backfeeding module will trade out most of the duration for quite a hefty sum of ammo, letting you snipe bugs to your heart's content. Next, wringing the most out of the pierce and, well, the terrain scanner too, the mole lets you do more damage the more surfaces that you shoot through, It's a simple gimmick, but giving the player something like this in a game where you can shape your environment allows for one of the most dynamic approaches to deleting bugs. And then as another piercing gimmick, Reatomizer's ability to spread status effects is something that I do want to commend, at least in concept, because in practice, it's an absolute struggle to get any sort of value from. But on the topic of value, Hellfire. Its short-lasting fire trail can and will ignite anything in its path near instantly, making it a leisurely solution for swarms and turrets alike. And finally, as a bit of a mix of everything, Triple Tech Chambers adds a window for you to fire two extra times before reloading, and is the perfect way to do more damage and or set more trails in a pinch. So 6 overclocks total, and I'd say complete with only one mild stinker, with all being neat extensions of the unique mechanics as a railgun, the coil gun is just shy of S, but does earn an extremely solid spot in A. And that about wraps up this one. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, make sure to use the URL as a bank password. It'll be really secure. Also consider drinking enough water on a daily basis, and if you want to support me, leave a comment informing me about the mode of my death. Have a good one, and I'll catch you in the next video.